Hello YouTube, hope you're having a lovely week so far. Today is August 2nd and the time has come. I am going to Paris and I am going to be competing in that tournament that I told you about a long time ago. I am pretty much packed in everything. I have organized a system which allowed me to get everything done within 2 days. But I had a lot of errands to run and a lot of work to finish, and that was a good 2 to 3 week process leading up to this trip. But I think that I have everything done. Oh wait, no I don't. I didn't post the flyers that I was supposed to post that my boss had asked me to do today. Okay, I'm gonna have to do that before my trip tomorrow. But it has been turbulent, no pun intended. But yeah, quite turbulent the last couple of weeks. I have had to deal with a lot of work stress, credit card stress, having to deal with, you know, lots of things involving the games. For example, I am supposed to compete in the team competition, and two of my teammates in the squad that I was supposed to bowl with, two of them went down with injuries, and now I'm not even sure if I'm going to bowl the team competition, to be honest. I'm still set for singles, I'm still set for doubles, but the team is very, very iffy. Sorry, my nose is itching, I'm not picking it, just scratching it. Anyway, maybe it is perhaps a blessing in disguise, because all things considering, leading up to my trip, I think that I'm just going to need to, you know, to have that small break. Now, I don't know if I'm going to advance in any of the semifinals or finals in any of the other divisions, but who cares? I'm in Paris. Ha! All right, so let's go ahead and let's take a look at all the things that I have packed. Turning off the light behind me. And I'm going to pack my flag now so I don't forget it. But we are going to start with my bowling bag. Alright, so never mind. I dragged my bowling bag back into the living room because the lighting is much better in here than in the hallway. But this is, this is my bowling bag. This is also going to be my carry-on. You're actually allowed to carry a bowling ball in your carry-on, and I'm taking my 13-pound Earth ball. I call it Earth because it's blue and green. And I will show you the other items in my carry-on, which include my uniform and a couple of other good luck charms, my bowling shoes, and so on and so forth. Ooh, one quick thing. These are the shoes. These aren't my bowling shoes. These are the shoes I'm actually going to wear on the plane. I custom made them myself. Pretty cool, huh? Here's everything else that I laid out. Here's some Team USA t-shirts, some running socks, a couple pairs of new jeans, my Adidas bag, and my Team USA cap, along with my sock hat. I mean, I know it's gonna be, I mean, it's summer, it's probably gonna be really hot over there, but I'll take it just in case. We are going to be doing the Rainbow Walk. So I got a pair of shoes that were, you know, that were appropriate for walking, power walking, running, and yeah, they fit very, very comfortably and breathe very well. Yeah, then I got some new flip-flops. They are quite durable. They were on sale, and they are powder blue. Now my suitcase is ready to be packed completely. All that's left is a good night's sleep, and posting those flyers tomorrow before I leave, and then it's to the airport and I fly out. All right, everybody, I'm headed to the airport now and my parents are dropping me off. I am a mixed bag of emotions right now. So I'm a little nervous, a little excited, but the rain should be tapering off pretty soon. I just a lot going on today. Hey, Mom. shoulder bag, carry-on, luggage. All right, checking, making sure 100%, yep, wallet, passport,
money.
All right. Hi, Dad.
Hi.
All right, here's Dallas. Rain's letting up, though. Yeah, I got stopped by TSA. They had to check my bowling ball, but my bowling ball went through. They just had to check it, though. How tired I am right now. It is 5:30 here in Ireland, but it is 1 o'clock back home and I am exhausted, but that's okay because I have another 2.5-3 hours till my next flight, so I'm gonna try to use that time to sleep. Oh crap, there's a big line. Never mind, there it is, the big line. Alright guys, I am at the shopping area of the Dublin airport. I forget which terminal. I am really tired right now. I did not sleep at all. The flight was turbulent pretty much from beginning to end. Yeah, first we had to get through the storms that were hitting the East Coast. And then we went through two areas of the jet stream, which really just kind of rocked the plane getting to Dublin. So I'm running on zero sleep right now. But I am on my way to Paris. I'm just waiting for the gate to be announced, and hopefully I can get some sleep at the gate, but it's not looking likely right now. Hey peeps, I finally arrived in Paris and honestly I think I probably had a combined 1 hour of sleep. It is noon right now and I'm here, but I'm really tired. This airport's confusing the shh out of me right now. Going to baggage claim now. Please be there, please be there, please be there. Hey YouTube, just woke up from a nap. So what happened after Ray met me at the airport, we took the RER train from the airport to our friend's place, and the train got stranded for like an hour. I mean, it just stopped, and we stood there for an hour, and it was such a pain. But we finally made it, I finally made it here, and took a shower, took a nap, and feel much better. Now we're gonna go out, and we're gonna enjoy the city. Okay, time to go see the city. Hi, Greg. Sit up, you sit up, you sit up, you sit up, you. Thank you.
like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light.
Now? Okay. I'm here in Paris.
Woohoo!
Hey everybody back home. Miss you all. Love you. Day two of my vlog. What's up guys? Good morning or bonjour from Paris. Yeah, so the reason I'm whispering is because my friend John is sleeping in the room next door, but we are about to do the rainbow walk and I have everything laid out for it. All right, so first is my official bench. Yep, and then I got my Nike running shorts. I really, really love these shorts and I thought that I lost them. And I'm part of the DC Front Runner, so I'm going to be wearing this. And then this was the bag that my badge came in, and a bunch of other cool stuff as well. This didn't come with it, I bought that at Target. It is a beautiful morning. Absolutely nice. We are about to get started pretty soon. The line's moving pretty quickly. Anyway, but it's really, really nice morning to do the walk. I was so afraid it was gonna be hot. Luckily, it's not now. I'm in. And I believe the mayor of Paris is going to actually be speaking before we walk, so this is pretty cool. And I'm just kind of looking around, seeing where everybody's from.
Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light. Like the cool blue light.
It's so quiet this morning. Make some noise, please, make some noise! Okay, just one person ready? Are we ready?
Yeah!
Miss Anne Hidalgo, Mayor of Paris, please!
This is Manuel Picot. I'm very proud to be with you, and we would like to open this village today. This place will be the rendezvous of all participants, Franciliens, Parisians and participants all the week long.
Today and for 1 week. Merci infiniment. D'abord, merci à Pascal et à Manuel qui ont porté pendant des années cette candidature, cette ambition pour Paris 2018. Et c'est un immense plaisir que de se retrouver là aujourd'hui. Depuis 2013, nous avons fait un long voyage. 2013, où c'était Cleveland. Cleveland qui décidait en fait de donner à Paris 2018.
Health. It's a day for prevention. And I hope to share with you some messages around prevention for a good, healthy sexual life, of course. And also for sport. Sport is very important, as you know, for all of us to stay in a very good health. Also a message of prevention because it's going to be very, very, very hot. during these days. So please drink a lot. Please be cautious. I don't want to have anyone hurt during this game.
Like the cool blue light.
And it has evolved into a series of symbolic events called the International Rainbow Memorial Run since 1998. This event pays tribute to the memories of artist Keith Haring, lesbian activist Ricky Stryker, Dr. Tom Waddell, the founder of the Gay Games, and to all family members whom the Gay Games have lost. Past editions of the International Rainbow Memorial Run, previous Gay Games hosts organized a Rainbow Run in San Francisco, Vancouver, Sydney, New York, Chicago, Cologne, and Cleveland.
Inclusion. The Gay Games have also been, as said before, a community response to the catastrophe of the AIDS epidemic in the 80s and the 90s. This trauma, this catastrophe, still impacts our communities today. This is how we work at Paris Sans Sida. This is our threshold strategy, fighting, staying critical, and sharing the good news.
I'm just going to read the names for this memorial moment. Phil Ainsworth, Drew Alia, Alan Amen, Zahn Artman, Bach,
Charles Clifton Jr.,
Roy Cole, Horace Collins, Marcus Cameron, Raoul Campagnon, Gerald,
Peter Fins Jingbones, Betty Flower, Terry Fox, Gary Fox,
Bill Concoy, Chris Connor.
Brothers in arms in this war that love has become. Like a mind to heal where the danger makes you numb. We fail under any rainbow. See my friends again. On nous laissant pas peut guérir de tout. Chers amis, chers amants, quel putain de temps pour les cœurs candides ouverts.
Live. Ça c'est pour la voix publique. Il y a une fontaine pour remplir, pour boire. Il y a une fontaine pour remplir les gourdes au 93 de la rue de Rivoli.
Madame Sally, ils sont tous partis. Allez, désolé. Je...
through the mist. Here we go. It's nice.